There are little ghosts and goblins at your house on Halloween. On Your Side's Ashley Reynolds shares some extra precautions to keep them safe.
Well, it is tough to have a childproof home, especially from Halloween through the holiday season. If you don't already have this number on your fridge or on your phone, now I know this font is small. I have this number right now on our website. We're talking about the Missouri Poison Center. If your child swallows something and is still breathing, call the number. You'll talk with a registered pharmacist or a nurse. Hey, it's free. Let's go over a few things that might seem harmless but could be dangerous around littles.
One of our most popular calls are the glow sticks.
And Julie Weber with the Missouri Poison Center says, while helpful at night, be careful.
These are very thin plastic, and when breaking them, it's easy for them to break in half, or if a young child might chew on them. And the chemical in here is dibutyl phthalate. It's not toxic. It's an irritant.
Wipe out the mouth and give them something to drink. If it's in their eye, flush. Button batteries are in some flashlights.
And that they can get stuck in the esophagus and cause a burn, or also down into the intestines. So very much a choking hazard.
If you have really small kiddos, no tiny spiders or eyeballs.
So this is actually a toy. It's a gel, kind of soft, squishy eyeball, but it can look like some of the gummy candies out there, like the gummy eyeballs. And it really doesn't chew easy or break down, that we have the risk of a child that can choke on this.
My 2-year-old would eat that.
It looks just like a gummy eyeball that I just saw at Target the other day.
Not all face paints are the same.
Really, you want to make sure that you have a product that says it's safety tested and non-toxic, because some of these are not, and children seem to be more with their sensitive skin. They can react to the different face paints. So not to spoil the evening, we always say at least 5 days to a week ahead of time, try them out on a small patch of the arm and really make sure they are not going to react to these paints.
For older kids, here's a warning about hair color sprays.
These products are inhalants, and inhalants can be abused, and so we need to be cautious.
We went over so many other hazards, and we simply don't have time to cover them all in a newscast, but I want to make sure you get this important information. So tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., you can watch the rest of our conversation with the Missouri Poison Center. There's a dry ice warning, and man, you see a lot of that in those punch bowls at those parties. Plus, we'll talk about all those smell-good fall candles, sprays and plug-ins, apple pie, pumpkin spice, and cinnamon. Make sure home smells so nice and wonderful, but maybe skip those smells if you have little ones. This is a conversation you'll want to share with your friends. And hey, you can find us on the KY3 News app, Roku, Apple TV, and Amazon Fire Stick. Lisa.
Thanks, Ashley. Now